Full Body Dumbbell Strength Workout for Women. Please like, share, comment and subscribe this video. Visit the Leptitox official homepage. Read our full Leptitox reviews, leptitoxes.blogspot.com. This dumbbell workout is a metabolic conditioning session as well as a strength workout. If you're getting bored with your current workout, give this fun routine a try. Workout description: if you have trouble sticking with your exercise regimen, it might be because it is a drag to do the same old cardio or weight training split, week after week. I have found that to keep my clients interested and excited, I have to create new exercise routines on a daily basis. We may repeat exercises but rarely do repeat whole routines. I want my clients to have fun and enjoy coming to my modest little garage gym. This little sequence is a full-body dumbbell strength workout as well as a metabolic conditioning program. You can use it as an alternative or in addition to your regular workouts. It is a great workout for groups as well as individuals. Each exercise is done for 20 seconds and then you rest for 10 seconds. Do the first exercise for 4 intervals, then move to the second exercise. After you complete the first 2 exercises, you do 10 burpees. Then move on to the next 2 exercises and use the timing and sets as outlined above. Do 10 burpees after every 2 exercises as listed below. Seated dumbbell press overview. The seated dumbbell press is a variation of the standing dumbbell press and an exercise used to strengthen the muscles of the shoulders. The overhead press is a foundational movement for establishing baseline strength and building a completely balanced physique. Utilizing dumbbells as opposed to performing with a barbell will allow the individual to strengthen each side of the muscle equally. The exercise can be included in shoulder workouts, push workouts, upper body workouts, and full body workouts. Seated dumbbell press instructions: set up an adjustable angle bench to 90 degrees and select the desired weight from the rack. Pick up the dumbbells from the floor using a neutral grip, palms facing in. Position the end of the dumbbells on your knees and sit down on the bench. Using a safe and controlled motion, kick your knees up one at a time in order to get each dumbbell into place. Once the dumbbells are in place, rotate your palms so they are facing forward. Take a deep breath, then press the dumbbells overhead by extending the elbows and contracting the deltoids. Slowly lower the dumbbells back to the starting position. The arms should be roughly 90 degrees or slightly lower depending upon limb lengths. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions. Seated dumbbell press tips. Keep your back flat against the pad throughout the duration of the exercise. Don't allow the head to jut forward excessively. Drive the bicep to the ear and exhale as you press. If you sense any pressure in your neck or traps during the movement, look to address a lack of thoracic spine extension or shoulder flexion. Keeping the elbows slightly bent at the top and not locking out entirely will help to keep tension on the shoulders. If you can't lock out the elbows overhead, then it may indicate a lack of shoulder mobility due to poor scapular upward rotation. Dumbbell upright row overview. The dumbbell upright row is an exercise used to build the muscles of the shoulder. It is a variation of the barbell upright row and mimics a lateral raise movement pattern. Upright rows are met with some controversy as many professionals view it as an exercise that promotes shoulder impingement. However, if performed appropriately, it can be beneficial in targeting the shoulders to promote lean muscle growth. Dumbbell upright row instructions. Select the desired weight from the rack and assume a shoulder width stance with a slightly narrower grip. Take a deep breath, then pull the dumbbells directly up the front of your body to chest height, keeping them as close as possible. Slowly lower the dumbbells back to the starting position under control. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions. Dumbbell upright row tips. Keep the elbows high but don't allow the upper arm to go past parallel as this may increase the risk of impingement. If you experience pain in the shoulders during the movement, then it may require a slight squeeze of the traps to elevate the shoulders and open up some of the subacromial space. Don't allow your back to arch as you pull the dumbbells up. Extra momentum used during the movement can potentially shift the load to other compensatory muscles, so try to limit excessive movement if possible. As you drive the elbows high, ensure the head doesn't jut forward. Dumbbell floor press overview. The dumbbell floor press is a variation of the floor press and an exercise used to strengthen the muscles of the triceps and chest. Primarily, the dumbbell floor press will target the muscles of the triceps. The limited range of motion effectively takes the chest somewhat out of the equation of the press. However, the chest can still be indirectly targeted when using the floor press. Simply focus on squeezing the pecs at the top of the movement. Floor presses, in generally, are particularly helpful for those looking to build stronger triceps to help with locking out more compound press variations. They can also be beneficial for bodybuilders trying to add mass to their triceps. Dumbbell floor press instructions. Begin sitting on the floor in an upright position with your legs straight and the dumbbells vertically balanced on the floor. Pick up each dumbbell and set it high in your hip crease while maintaining a tight grip. Slowly lay back while keeping the dumbbells close to your chest and bend your knees to roughly 45 degrees and move your feet up slightly. Press the weights to full extension by contracting your triceps and chest. Slowly lower the weight until both elbows touch the floor, then press both dumbbells back to the starting position. Repeat for the desired number of repetitions. To complete the exercise, simply lower the weights to the ground in controlled drop fashion. It should be a smooth motion but not one requiring excessive effort or one that puts the shoulder under unnecessary risk. Dumbbell floor press tips: maintain more tension through the pecs by not locking out the elbows entirely. Keep the weights slightly tilted at a 45-degree angle in order to keep the elbows in a neutral position. Don't allow the dumbbells to collide at the top of each rep. Bouncing them together may cause you to lose stability within the shoulder and injure yourself. Squeeze the dumbbells as tight as possible to improve a phenomenon known as irradiation, which promotes greater shoulder stability. Don't bounce the elbows off the floor at the bottom of the rep. Doing so may result in injury due to the compressive forces being generated between the weight and the floor. Ensure you maintain some tension in your abs and don't allow your lower back to excessive arch. Dumbbell flies overview. The dumbbell fly utilizes a chest fly movement pattern to isolate the muscles for the chest to better help the muscles grow and become stronger. The dumbbell fly is often thought of as a classic bodybuilding movement, as the goal of the exercise is to isolate the chest for aesthetic purposes. The movement itself can be used to help build a stronger bench press but isn't typically thought of from an increased performance standpoint. Thus, this movement is best reserved for traditional chest workouts in bodybuilding style splits. Dumbbell flies instructions: pick up the dumbbells off the floor using a neutral grip, palms facing in. Position the ends of the dumbbells in your hip crease, and sit down on the bench. To get into position, lay back and keep the weights close to your chest. Once you are in position, take a deep breath, then press the dumbbells to lock out at the top. Slightly retract your shoulder blades, unlock your elbows, and slowly lower the dumbbells laterally while maintaining the angle at your elbow. Once the dumbbells reach chest level, reverse the movement by squeezing your pecs together and bringing the dumbbells back to their starting position. Without allowing the dumbbells to touch, start the next repetition, and continue until the set is completed. Dumbbell flies tips: imagine you're trying to hug a tree while completing the exercise. Don't squeeze the dumbbell handles excessively tight, as this can over-recruit the forearms and biceps, thereby reducing activation of the pecs. Avoid touching or banging the dumbbells together at the top of each repetition in order to keep constant tension on the intended muscle groups. Always keep a slight bend in the elbows and never lower the weight to the point where you get any sort of pain and pressure at the front of the shoulder joint. If you're feeling pain within the shoulder joint itself, specifically at the front, ensure your shoulder blades are slightly retracted and try to keep the shoulder girdle packed. Keep your feet flat on the floor, focus solely on keeping your elbows bent and activating your pecs. Ensure you maintain some tension in your abs and don't allow your lower back to excessive arch. Abdominal air bike, aka bicycle, overview. The abdominal air bike is probably the most feared abdominal movement from anyone who's performed an at-home ab workout video. The bicycle exercise targets the whole abdomen and places constant tension on the midsection as you go through the motions on both sides. This exercise is an advanced variation of a crunch. It can be performed for timed sets or as a set with a fixed rep range. Abdominal air bike, aka bicycle, instructions: lay supine in a relaxed position with your arms behind your head and legs straight. Exhale as you raise one knee towards your face while driving the opposite elbow to the knee. Once your abs are fully contracted, slowly lower yourself back to the starting position and repeat on the opposite side. Complete for the assigned number of repetitions. Abdominal air bike, aka bicycle, tips: exhale hard like you're blowing out candles on a cake and hold the contraction for a second in order to improve mind-muscle connection. If your lower back bothers you during this exercise, choose more anti-extension and anti-rotation based movements. Avoid putting the hands behind the head as this can lead to excess strain upon the neck. Please like, share, comment and subscribe this video. Visit the Leptitox official homepage. Read our full Leptitox reviews, leptitoxes.blogspot.com. Thanks for watching my video.